So if you're taking calculus 2 right now, then you need to know how to solve this kind of integrals, especially by doing trig substitution. And I know when you see this kind of integrals for the first time, they are scary. They are difficult. I totally understand. Especially when I was a student, I had a hard time with them as well. Anyways, though, my goal here is to help you understand how to solve this one. And I will also give you guys a bonus because this one can actually be done with just U substitution. So check this out. So how do we do it though? First, you should get the notes right here. We have x squared plus 4. 4 is the same as 2 squared. So right here, square root of x squared plus a squared. I'm going to do a tangent substitution right here. And then you guys can check out my other video because I gave you guys like an introduction and also more details on this thing right here. So first notice that 4 is the same as 2 squared. So x squared plus 2 squared in the square root, I'm going to let x equal to 2 times tangent. Tangent is the key right here, right? So 2 tangent theta. And then we're just going to do the usual business. We have to get the dx. So I will look at this and differentiate both sides. So dx equals 2, and you have to know your derivatives really well. What's the derivative of tangent x? Well, tangent theta in this case. The answer for that is secant squared theta. And as a bonus, I'm going to give you guys a blank sheet of derivative table. Make sure you know all the derivatives. So go ahead and practice them, and then check out my other video to fill in the answers. So we have the integral. 1 is 1, but let me write that down later. X is now 2 tangent theta, and then we have to square that thing, and then square root. Again, the x squared is 2 tangent theta, and then we have to square that, and then plus 4. On the top, we have the 1. Dx is all this, so multiply by 2 secant squared theta d theta. Okay, so picked up the correct substitution, differentiate that, and then throw that into the original. So we go from the x world to the theta world. And don't forget about the dx or d theta. This right here is a bigger crime if you forget about it compared to the plus c. I'm okay if you forget about the plus c on my exams for if you are just doing indefinite integral. But if you forget the dx, then this is all wrong. You don't even have the chance to end up with worry about plus d or not. So make sure this right here is crucial, right? Now, I would recommend you guys to focus on the square root part. Here, we have 2 squared, that's 4, and then tangent squared theta plus 4. This is why we let x equal to 2, because 2 squared is 4. That's why earlier is x squared plus a squared in the formula. Then we can factor out the 4, and then tangent squared theta plus 1. And then remember these right here, they all have square roots. Square root of 4 is just a regular 2. But what's tangent squared plus, actually let's write it down like this. What's tangent squared theta plus 1 though? Right here, you're going to use secant squared theta. Tangent squared theta plus 1 will give you secant squared theta. Okay, so this right here is 4 times secant squared theta, but they are all inside of the square root. Square root of 4 is 2, square root of secant squared is just secant theta. Okay, that looks pretty good, but I'm going to write it down nice for you guys. So this is the integral, 1 over, this is 2 squared, which is 4 tangent squared theta, and then times the blue 2 secant theta, and then times 2 secant squared theta d theta. Have a look. 2 and 2 cancel, secant theta and one of them cancel. That's pretty good. So I'm going to erase the board right here. So now we are going to get, we have 1 over 4. We can put that on the outside of the integral, make it easier on our eyes. And then we have secant theta on the top over tangent squared theta. Okay, so what do we do next though? A general strategy when you're doing trig integrals is that try to work with sine cosine. Here, let's try to do this. This is 1 over 4. Secant is the same as 1 over cosine. And then tangent is the same as sine over cosine, but that's a square, so sine square over cosine square. So let's try that and see what happens. Okay, complex fraction, I will multiply the top and bottom by cosine square theta, so that this and that will cancel completely. And then the top, we will just have 1 cosine theta left. So this is 1 over 4 integral. On the top, we just have cosine theta over the bottom is sine square theta. Now, is this easier? Well, not compared to this one right here. It's easier because now we can just do a regular U sub. Because the derivative of sine theta, right? The derivative of sine theta will give us cosine theta d theta. And that's exactly what we have on the top. Notice we are just putting u to be sine to the first power theta, not the second power, okay? So this becomes 1 over 4 integral. The whole thing on the top like this is our du. On the bottom we have sine, which is u. So we have u squared on the bottom, and then just 1 over that, and then du. Okay, like this. So as you can see, we have done trig sub and also u sub here. So told you, it's pretty difficult. And then finally, we are going to do what? Remember, in the U world, most likely you are just going to do either the reverse power rule or knowing the derivative from the table, right? The derivative of y is equal to this. In this case, we can do a reverse power rule. So I'm going to do 1 over 4 integral, write that as u to the negative 2 power. And then add 1 to it, which is negative 1, divided by the new power, so divided by negative 1. So this right here is going to be negative 1 over 4, and then u to the negative 1, which is 1 over u, and then that's all done. Now that's pretty much it for the integration part. But now we just have to go back to the theta world and then the x world. Okay, so negative 1 over 4, the u is sine theta, so that's sine theta. Okay, but how do we go back to the x world though? Well, here's the triangle method that I would recommend. If you look at this right here, divide both sides by 2, then we can get tangent theta equals x over 2. And then draw a right triangle. Put a right angle here, d theta here for consistency purpose. So that way you can see tangent, which is opposite over adjacent, label here, label here. And you have to figure out the hypotenuse. And for the hypotenuse, you just open the square root first. This is the longest side, so you're going to add the square of this and the square of that. Let's put down the x square first, and you add this square. And then you can see that this right here gives us the negative 1 over 4, 1 over sine theta. You can just look at this picture. Sine is opposite over hypotenuse, which we will just have x over square root of x squared plus 4, like that. But this is 1 over that, we can turn that upside down. So finally, we can write this as negative, putting this on the top. So square root of x squared plus 4. This 4 is on the bottom, along with this x, so just like this. And we are all done now, so at the very end, I will put on the plus c, just like that, okay? I know it involves a lot of steps, but it's a good practice. This is a good practice to really understand how to work out difficult integrals. And truth to be told, there's an easier way, but it's not so easy to see, but let's have a look. So check this out. First, you'll notice that we have x squared on the outside, and then on the inside, we have x squared plus 4. I'm going to factor out an x squared. So this is the integral 1 over x squared times the square root of x squared times, this right here will be 1, but this right here will be what? I will have to do 4 divided by x squared. Let me write it as 4x to the negative 2. So this right here becomes the integral 1 over this x squared stays, but times square root of x squared, which is just x to the first power, and then we take square root of this, 1 plus 4x to the negative 2. Okay, I think some of you can see already. This is just equal to x to the third power on the bottom. But why don't we put this on the top? Because that way we can get the integral, this goes to the top, we get x to the negative 3 over square root of 1 plus 4x to the negative 2 dx. Now, isn't this so wonderful? How come? Yes, if you told me, if we can just take the u to be this, because now you see, this right here is just power 1 less than that. So if you let u equal to 1 plus 4x to the negative 2, and differentiate both sides real quick, du equals, the derivative of this is 0. Put this to the front, we get negative 8, and then minus 1, so it's x to the negative 3 dx. This right here, we have the function part. We need the negative 8, but it's okay. Let's just go ahead and multiply by negative 8 and then divide by negative 8. So they cancel, we didn't change anything. Now, this becomes 1 over negative 8. Integral, all this is just our du. And then we have 1 over, this is just square root of u, du. And then we can just do the reverse power rule. This is negative 1 over 8, integral u to the negative 1 half power, because the square root is on the bottom. Go ahead, add 1 to the power, we get positive 1 half, divided by the new power, which is 2 over 1. Reduce this, we get negative 1 over 4, and then we have u to the 1 half power, which is just the square root of u, and u is that, 1 plus 4x to the negative 2. And then, done. But wait, is this really the same as the answer that we had earlier? The truth is, yes, they are. So, this is how we can do it. We can continue to simplify this right here. When we have negative exponent, we can bring that down. So this becomes negative 1 over 4 square root of 1 plus 4 over x squared for that. Okay? And then let's just get a common denominator. We need the x squared. So we get negative 1 over 4 square root. This and that is x squared plus 4 over x squared. And now, ladies and gentlemen, negative 1 over 4 stay in the front. Here on the top, we have square root of x squared plus 4. On the bottom, take the square root of x squared, we just get x, which if you put them together, you will get that. So they are indeed equal. Hopefully this video is helpful, and for more tutorials on calculus 2 topics, you can check out my channel, check out my playlist. These videos will help you master your integration skills. Right? That's it.